Hey guys, today we are going to talk about the Atoma 400 and 600 grit stones. Okay, I use stones and plates interchangeably, so if I'm saying stones in this video, I'm talking about the plates. Okay, so forgive me if I am not using the right terminology. I'm just used to saying the word stone more than plates. But yes, these two stones, plates slash plates, are extremely similar. And you know, I was doing some research online and I really can't find any information on the 600 and 1200 grit stones, so I went out and purchased some. These are actually combo plates I got from my buddy Yugen, and these are really cool because he got them. He's got the, you can choose any combination you want, but I have the 140 and the 600 combination, and the 400, so 140 and 600 combination, and I have the 400 and the 1200 combination. So really cool, really compact system to have. But today we're only going to talk about the 400 and the 600 grit version. All right, so from your vantage point, they look pretty much identical. I think they are really, really close in terms of grit ratings, and they feel the same. I mean, with your eyes closed, if you're feeling the areas where you've just sharpened on and the stone, the stones have been worn down a little bit, they feel exactly the same. Okay, so which one should you actually buy? And so here's the thing. In terms of scratch pattern, they are identical. I couldn't tell the difference between the two stones. I really couldn't. The only way I could have told the difference was I kept the knife with the stone that it was just sharpened on, and if I didn't do that, I actually would lose track of which stone is which. In terms of hand feel, they feel exactly the same once you've used them. Out of the box, they do feel a little different. The 400 does feel a little bit rougher. They actually do wear down, and they actually get quite smooth, which is a really good thing because they don't retain that really harsh scratch pattern that you normally would see from a diamond plate, okay? But in terms of what stones you should buy, I think for me, the differentiator is this. If you are the type that likes to flatten your stone once in a while, only when it's needed, go with the 400. If you are the type that likes to sharpen your or flatten your stones often, perhaps once a week, perhaps once every time you sharpen, go with the 600, okay? Here's why. The 400 can act as your core stone and flatten if you need it to, okay? And as you actually use the 400, it actually will become a lot finer and maybe even close to, in terms of feel, like a 600 grit or 800 grit stone, okay? But it can also have the aggressiveness of the 400 grit, for a flattener. If you guys need to repair chips on a knife or need to, grind away a certain part of the stone that's worn out, kind of weird, the 400 is great for that. So if you are the type that likes to flatten your stone more often, the 600 would actually make more sense because it takes off less material per stroke. And it also is a finer stone, so it's not going to be your stone that you use every single time. Some people like to go through a whole range of grits. They go to the 400, 800, 1000, and then 3000, 6000. I'm not that guy. I really go 1000, 6000 every time I sharpen, and I go to a lower grit if I really need to fix chips or rebevel my knife. But for those who just want a diamond plate that they can use often, you go with the diamond plate that has a finer grit, because then you actually will save the life of your stones, and you also have the straightness of a stone that you don't have to worry about flattening. And this can also serve as your flattening stone for your lower grit, like your 200, 400 grit stones, or your higher grit, 1000, 3000, 6000 grit stones. So that's really the main difference. This one can, you definitely can use the 400 on a 6000 grit stone. It actually will leave a slight scratch pattern, so that's the thing. If you are the type that likes to work on your higher, if you like to polish on a higher grit stone, like a 4,000, 5,000, or 6,000 grit stone, go with the 600, okay? If you max out at 4,000, 5,000, go with the 400. It's probably a little better for you. So, but in terms of performance, they really perform the same. I really enjoy them. These are my favorite diamond plates that I've used. I've used DMTs, I've used some other off Chinese brand stuff, which is I don't recommend, but these are fantastic. They are a little pricey, right? But if you guys were looking for a plate, a dual sided plate, or just a stone that can replace your coarse and medium stones, the 600 is a great stone for that. The 400 really is not going to replace anything. It's going to be used in place of the 140. It's not going to be as aggressive as a 140, but it can definitely flatten just as well, and it takes off less material, and it can be used more often. Well, that is it for this video. Thank you guys for watching. If you guys enjoyed it, give the video a thumbs up and let me know if there are videos or the sharpening videos that you guys want to see. I've got a lot of knives coming in. I'm waiting for all of them to arrive at the, or not at the same time, but for all of them to arrive before I do a big knife comparison, especially Japanese versus Western European knives. It's going to be a very fun series. And yeah, that will be it. Thank you guys for watching again. See you next time.